Hi there, welcome to this video on database normalization. In this video, we will learn about normalization and the first normal form. What is normalization? It means database design to minimize redundancy or duplicity. The concept of normalization DBMS was introduced by Edgar Cord in the years after he invented the concept of the relational model of storing data. There are various degrees of normalization. 1nf is the first normal form, 2nf or second normal form, 3nf or third normal form, and so on. Each degree of normalization means more strict design than the previous degree. If a table is in 2nf, it means that it is already in 1nf. If a table is in 3nf, it means that it is already in 1nf and 2nf. What is 1nf? First normal form means that each table has only columns relevant to that table. Each table has a primary key. Primary key means a value that is unique in every row of a table. Each table has no repeating groups. Now let us see examples that are not in the first normal form. This is the customer table. Its columns are customer ID, name, address, and support contact name. The problem is that support contact does not belong to the customer table. This gives rise to issues. For example, if a customer row is deleted, the support contact data also gets deleted. Another issue, it is not possible to store data for support contacts who are not assigned to any customer. The solution is, since support contact is a separate entity, it should have its separate table. Another problem example, this is the employee table. Its columns are first name, last name, and job title. The problem is duplicate rows like row 1 and row 4. This gives rise to issues. Which row should we update if only one Annie Smith is promoted? Or which row should we delete if one Annie Smith leaves the organization? The solution is to have a primary key in the table. The primary key employee ID makes every row in the table unique. So this Annie Smith, who is a support executive, has an employee ID of 1. And this Annie Smith, who is a support executive, has an employee ID of 4. Another problem example, this is the customer table. Its columns are customer ID, name, address, phone number 1, phone number 2, and phone number 3. The problem is repeating values of phone numbers. This gives rise to issues. For example, Abe has only one phone number, so the space for phone number 2 and phone number 3 is wasted. Also say, David has 4 phone numbers, but we can store a maximum of 3 phone numbers only. The solution is to have a separate table for phone numbers. In order to convert the customer table to first normal form, it is needed to have two tables. Customer table with columns, customer ID, name, and address, and customer phone number table with columns, customer ID, and phone number. Now, a customer can have maybe no phone numbers, one phone number, or more than one phone number. For example, Abe has customer ID of 1, and in the customer phone number, customer ID 1 has only one row, which is the phone number for Abe. Ben has customer ID of 2. For customer ID of 2, we see that there are 3 rows, and the phone numbers are 22, 33, and 44. Also, the customer data is in the customer table. and phone number data is in the customer phone number table. Now customer table has customer ID as a primary key. Customer phone number table has customer ID and phone number as the primary key together. In this design, no space is wasted. If a phone number is deleted, the customer does not get deleted. Now we have seen database normalization explained with examples. Let us see how to test if each table is in 1NF. We need to check, does each column belong to the table? Is there a primary key? Are there no duplicate rows? Are there no repeating columns? Are there no multiple values in any column in any row? In this normalization tutorial for beginners, we saw normalization in database with example problems and database normalization example on the customer table. This was regarding 1NF. See you in my next video on 2NF. Thank you.